Great work, Sammy. You just argued your way into spending Saturday night with three Dianes.
That's right. That Sumner guy's a major brain, Sam.
Yeah, and he's an intellectual pit bull, Sammy. If you sense his fear, he'll attack. Reduce you to a pile of blubbering flesh right in front of your sweet pea there.
That seemed kind of nasty, doesn't it?
Ooh, it's mean, Sam.
Yeah. But it's not like I'm stupid, is it? Oh, my God. What am I doing here? I'm going to look like an idiot.
Sam, it's going to be okay. Just talk about something that you know about and they don't. Say, something like your apartment.
Coach, I don't think everyone's going to want to talk about my apartment.
Of course not. They'd look stupid trying.
No, you know, Diane's right. I'm going to embarrass her.
Sammy, believe it or not, I think I have a simple solution to all this. Look, he's a literature professor, right?
Yeah, right.
War and Peace is the greatest novel ever written. You read it between now and Saturday. All right, drop a few comments over dinner. You're off to the races.
War and Peace, this is a good book?
Oh, yeah, well, they say the first 800 pages are a little bit slow, but it shoots right off after.
Wait a second. What are we talking about? I got 5 days. How long is this book?
Well, I've delivered a few for the book clubs, and it's, about 3.5 pounds paperback.
Forget it, Sam. Nobody can read 4 ounces a day.
No, listen. If this is the best book ever written, then I'm gonna read it. Matter of fact, I'll go get it right now. What was the name again?
War and Peace. You have to write that down?
And misspell it?
The apartment, Sam. The apartment.